fighting to get back what we have lost in terms of immigrant rights and to keep fighting for a more permanent permanent solution and permanent legislation as we always have. And in the meantime, I'm waiting to see what USCIS when they will announce the reopening of the program and to allow folks to re to apply, newly apply, and to renew their DACA status. It's hugely exciting. It's the historic day. And now I would like to pass it along to Andai, who will be the next to share some words.
Good morning, everyone. Hi, everyone. I want to go ahead and thank both Nu Dulce and the Attorney General for their words. And I think that they've pretty much summed up everything, if not more than what most of us, all of us are feeling in this moment. I personally, my name is Andi McAndrew. I'm a recent first-generation graduate from California State Polytechnic University, Pomona, a current legal fellow and aspiring attorney. And so I think that today this is a big win. This is huge. This is what all of us have been fighting for since the inception of the program, since before the inception of the program. And when I think that today speaks volumes to the anxiety and that most of us have been feeling since President Trump got into office, since the rescission of the program, and since it has been brought forth in the Supreme Court. It was weighing heavily on all of our hearts. It has been weighing heavily on not just our hearts, but our allies and folks who have been standing with us, who feel for us, whose offices we work in, or whose spaces we are a part of. And so I think today is a win, not just for us, but for folks who stand with us. And I think that that is probably the most important part because it shows what America truly values, regardless of what President Trump says. I think this win, this shows that the Supreme Court stands with us, that multiple states stand with us, California stands with us, and our allies stand with us, and they will continue to stand with us. We were already. Many of us, I know myself included, we were preparing for the worst, but expecting the best. And today, I think that this win speaks volumes to that preparation. Many of us were standing anxiously by this past week on Monday, on Thursday. I myself was up bright and early, waiting by the computer, waiting to see what would happen. And as soon as the decision was out, tears erupted from, I'm sure, not just my eyes, but from everyone who is a DACA recipient or has members in their family who are DACA recipients, because we genuinely just didn't know what to expect. And so I think today, for the first time, there's a sigh of relief within our community. There is a celebration to be had. But at the same time, we all understand that this fight isn't over. We all understand that there
Yep.